Hello and welcome to another episode of the Newcastle United Save on the Football Manager 2021 beta. It's the last of this season, two games, Crystal Palace and Man United, and we've got a chance to secure Champions League football. Since you last saw the 1-0 win over Sheffield United and the 4-1 win over Leeds United, we've had some mixed form. We beat Tottenham for the third time in the season, 3-1. I thought things are absolutely hunky-dory. Life can't get better than this. Then, 2-0 down against Villa within about 10 minutes. Came back to win 3-2. Morelos scored in added time. Absolutely superb. Somehow lost to Fulham, though. Alexander Mitrovic getting payback, I suppose. 1-1 against West Brom, even worse. They are bottom of the league, I think. Absolutely terrible. Somehow beat Man City 3-2. We're on absolute fire. Saint-Maximin scored and a Wilson double. And then drew 0-0 with Everton. Which brings us on to today's games, which is Crystal Palace, who are in 19th, and Manchester United, who are in 1st, and they haven't won the league yet, annoyingly. I was hoping it would be all sealed up so they could just not really care about what happens and we could beat them, but no. And as you can see, as things stand, we have already secured a Euro Cup or Europa League place. We can't finish lower than 5th with two games to go because Chelsea have already played one of theirs. However, we can possibly finish 4th and catch Man City. Right now, we can still catch Arsenal too. We're 2 points behind Man City and 4 behind Arsenal. Let's get into things. I'm quite worried. We're probably going to lose to Crystal Palace. They need to win to stand a chance of staying up. Too much stress. The team for the first game today against Palace is Dubravka, Jedvaj. Garcia is back fit, thankfully he had a little injury. Lascelles, Dummett, Lewis also injured, so that's not ideal. But Paul Dummett is a goal scoring machine. If you've not seen on my Twitter, I'll enter the video now. You try me once, you make for more. Longstaff and Coop Miners with Christie ahead of him, Fraser on the right, Saint-Maximin on the left doing his thing with Wilson up top, Darlot, Frimpong, Shelvey, Almiron, Chervey, Carroll and Morelos all ready to go from the bench.
You absolutely, undoubtedly, unquestionably, 100% completely suck!
We are underway at St James's Park. Elsewhere, Manchester City play Leicester. Obviously, Leicester are hoping to finish 6th. I don't think they can. Can't they? They've got 2 games to go. They can if they win, but Kouyaté heads over. Sakho throws it on to McCarthy. Flicks it on. It's hoofed clear, sorry, by Garcia, I think it was. And Nathaniel Klein. We're not really in it too much, but Saint-Maximin nicks in as we look to break. 10 minutes before half-time. A goal now would be ideal. Alan Saint-Maximin does so. My darling, you with the headband, you are different gravy. What a finish that was. That is Alan Saint-Maximin all over. Nicks the ball, nicks in, wins the ball, breaks, goes himself with an emphatic finish. I'm not in focus, it's all gone Pete Tong, but what a run that was from Big Al, and a great finish. What a boy, different gravy, I tell you that much. But a Palace corner before half-time. They hit the post as well, all over the shop. And Gaita, he goes long, but only as far as Paul Dummett, superb. And Alan Saint-Maximin takes the ball down on his chest and shoots wide, unfortunately, this time. And that will probably be it before half-time, which we will take all the way to the bank. We're 1-0 up right now, it's 1-1 between Leicester and Man City, which is also very, very good for us. Let's get a second goal. Let's tie this up nice and easy. Let's relegate Palace is what I'm trying to say. And the second half is underway at St James' Park and there's a highlight right away. This could be a Newcastle goal, then I'd be very, very happy about that. Coop Miners out wide to Ryan Fraser. Fire it in, please, little Ryan, with your little legs. He does so. Christie shot blocked. What's going on now? Coop Miners shot blocked by Saint-Maximin. That's not what we want. As Zaha breaks, Michy Batshuayi, good tackle by Lascelles, great intervention, as we go again, do we? Saint-Maximin again, wonder run, Alan, wonder run, if you fancy it, then go on, mate, why not? He puts it in, Callum Wilson, 2-0, right at the start of the second half, and we find our second goal, wonderful stuff, great play by Saint-Maximin once again, and Callum Wilson has bagged his 23rd goal of the season. That man's been on fire, the competition from Morelos has only helped. What a ball that is from Saint-Maximin on his weak foot. Gita gets a hand to it, but too powerful from Wilson. Superb stuff.
Irrelevant, boring, old, yesterday's news. Out of the way, excuse me, we're coming in.
Over an hour played now as Paul Dummett throws it on for Saint-Maximin. Everything's been going through him lately. A free kick. Why has he been sent off? Did he stamp on his heel or something? Fair enough. Well, in that case, I suppose we'll maybe make a couple changes to rest some legs before Manchester United. After this attack, however, Christie takes it down for the ball from Fraser. It's a Maxman shot blocked. Is that it? Yeah, Viona yellow. We don't want him to get sent off. Coop Miners now. Fire it forward, he does. Sam Maxman again, another shot blocked. Paul Dummett down the left-hand side. Go on, Paul. Marauding fullback down the left-hand side. And here he is again, after Lascelles found him. Yeah, go on, mate. Longstaff hits it from there. Why not? He does. 3-0. It's time for changes. We'll make a couple, rest some legs once we see the replay. What a goal that is from Sean Longstaff. Fifth goal of the season. He's actually been really, really good. A mainstay in this team throughout the whole season and only got better with Coop Miners alongside him, giving him a bit more freedom to go forward and do things like that. Absolutely wonderful. Well done, Sean. Yes, lad. Oh, the Geordies love it, I'm sure. Okay, I was about to make the changes, but Coop Miners got another set piece. It goes in towards the back post. Van Aanholt, the former Newcastle and Sunderland man, cut it out. But Mishi Batshuayi, the Batman, comes long. Go on then. Yeah, well done, Sean. Superb stuff. Now, are we going to go again? Get another goal. Why not? Tin Yed vibe. Coming down the left-hand side, almost ran out of pitch. It's on the right-hand side as well. A bit worrying because it's the opposite side to what he plays on. But Sam Maxman's come inside. He doesn't care about sides. Who cares? Ryan Fraser, launch it in, mate. No, Longstaff once again from range. This time, not good enough. And it's time for changes now, okay? Sam Maxman has been superb, but with the game against Manchester United in mind, he does come off for Miguel Almiron. And Christie, likewise, for Jonjo Shelvey. Coop Miners drops back a little bit. Let's just tighten things up. No need for anything silly. Maybe even keep a clean sheet for once. That would be wild. I say with that, but we drew 0-0 with Everton, but we didn't score 3 in that game. That's the main thing. Maybe we'll make another change after this set piece, however. Fraser launches it in, and it's headed clear by Mamadou Sakho. Bless you. As Van Aanholt comes clear, he's through on goal. Great save by Dubravka. Marauding run from their left back this time. Not quite Paul Dummett, though, is he? No, let's be honest. And Eze with the subsequent corner, though. Let's just get this clear. Nothing stupid. We'll make the final change. Well done, Big Jamal. Final change is inbound. And I hope you're excited. I know I am. With just under 10 minutes to go, Alfredo Morelos is going to come on. See what he can do. Maybe he'll bag a goal. Who knows? Let's just keep him happy. Save him punching people and all that good stuff. But Fraser puts a corner in. It's headed clear by Blaise. It's not Blaise, it's Mamadou Sakho, but he says Blaise in the video of him on a motorbike in France, and he just comes across Blaise Matuidi, and it's quality stuff. Good content.
Paris, c'est petit. Regardez qui je croise. Mon gars, c'est moi. Blaise. Mon gars.
But Paul Dummett comes on the left-hand side now after another huge run from Van Aanholt. It's weird that he's the player that gets left up at corners. He's not even that small, so it's very unusual. But Paul Dummett, here he is. Almiron in. Morelos heads over. He'll be raging. He's going to punch me at full time, even if we do keep a clean sheet and win. Can't wait for that. But into added time we go, and that'll be it. Great win. I presume Man City haven't won, have they? Maybe they have. They move up the table. Or hopefully maybe just a draw. That would be ideal. We'll find out in just a little second, shall we? Let's see. Terrific performance, very, very good, it's all great. What happened with Man City? Unfortunately, they did win, that's annoying. Castagne's done us no favours there by getting sent off, cheers mate. But as you can see, right now, 1 point behind Arsenal, they've got a game in hand, but 2 behind Man City. It goes into the final day. Will we get there, and will we get Champions League football? Ah, that's why Arsenal weren't playing in the league. They were too busy winning the FA Cup. Brilliant, against Leeds, who knocked us out, so even better. However, they do win their game in hand against West Ham, meaning we are now 4 points behind them and 2 behind Man City, but it's not over yet. After such a great performance against Crystal Palace, we're going to go with the exact same team. It's an absolutely huge game. We need to win to get Champions League football, and we have a chance of ruining their title hopes. They've done it to us before, so let me tell you, you know exactly what I'm going to say. I will love it. Love it if we beat them.
I will love it if we beat them. Love it.
Yep, pretty scary team though. Oh dear lord. A highlight straight as the game kicks off at St James's Park, and they've given away. Ryan Christie's nicked in. Ryan Christie's had his shot tipped over the bar by David De Gea. That would have been some start. He takes the corner though, and he'll look to find a Newcastle man. He doesn't. He finds Alex Telles, who in turn finds Bruno Fernandes, basically. But elsewhere, we're looking at Everton versus Man City. Everton, we have nothing to play for, so that's not any use. And Arsenal versus Tottenham. Tottenham, by the way, 15th. Nowhere near it this season. Might not even get 40 points. Still might stay up. But if they could do us a favour, then it'd be much, much, much appreciated. Tin Yed Vai, his throwing Doesn't find a Newcastle man. Coop Miners now, though. We recycle it. San Maximan. It's with Coop Miners. They're playing between those two now. Ryan Christie. Hit it. Hit it. Shot blocked. Twill Dummett. Fires it in. Wilson. His shot blocked. What is going on? Coop Miners now. I presume that'll probably be it, will it? Yes, it will. Lemonek. Stress. Even more stress if they score here. Fernandes. Corner. In. Van de Beek. Hit the woodwork. And they come clear. We come clear. Sorry. Paul Dummett. No. Pogba collects. Basically the same person, really, isn't it? Whew. Panic over. No, not panic. Over Paul Dummett. Now he's back, way back in his own half. That's not where we want Paul Dummett. We want him doing that. Oh, I was about to say, do that kind of thing, playing Callum Wilson in mind, but no. Mason Greenwood now running at the back three, back four, back three. Where did that come from? Not playing the back three the whole series. Rashford taking it down. That's offside. Wan-Bissaka with a throw in. He only finds Jamal Lascelles, who in turn finds Van de Beek. We're just giving it to each other, back to each other. Nobody wants to keep the ball. Well, apparently they want to keep the ball now as Rashford comes into the box. That's definitely a penalty. No, he won the ball. He won the ball. All right, okay, I thought that was a certain penalty. Dubravka goes long, gives it back to Wan-Bissaka. That's not what you want. Mason Greenwood cutting inside, and Rashford in acres of space once again shoots straight at Dubravka once again. Oh, dear Lord. Right, what's going to happen here? Is that it? He goes long. Callum Wilson wins the header, nods it down to Ryan Fraser, who skips by one, in, Ryan Christie, 1-0 up we go, that is just what you want, half an hour on the clock, 10th goal of the season, what a signing he's been. I was a bit skeptical about bringing him in, I won't lie about that, but he's been absolutely immense. I think he's maybe third for assists, and that's 10th goal of the season as well. On the other side and then diving further to the other side. Not sure what that was about, but who cares? We'll take it. How do things stand? We're still fifth for now, and Sean Longstaff's got injured. That's not good. Guess Shelby comes on then. Oh, no. Oh, dear Lord. Oh, I was about to see what's happening in the Man City game, but Garcia now, the former Man City man, back with Dubravka, and they're just playing between those two, apparently. Do you want to give it to anyone else? Yeah, Jamal. Okay, good stuff. Coop Miners. Right, just triangles in the back here, is it? Right, brilliant. Out wide to Ryan Fraser, though, finally. A little bit of attacking prowess from the young man, please. He's 27 now. Wilson! Oh, he's offside. Oh, what a finish, though. Great stuff. Good sign, let's be honest. But, unfortunately, offside. I think he's been offside more than he has been on this season. It's like having Papi Cisse back. That man just lived offside. But, regardless, right, what is the Man City score? It's 0-0 right now. So, if Everton have gone up...
Up the Duffies.
Everton have gone up. I think they might have a better goal difference than us. But I'm not sure how much by. Oh, dear Lord. The final day drama is real. I don't know what's happening with Liverpool either for Manchester United's title hopes. But Van de Beek into Pogba. No, please don't concede before half-time. Please don't concede before half-time. We've conceded before half-time. Oh, dear Lord. A great finish from Marcus Rashford. Maybe he would have scored more if he was actually focused on football rather than feeding kids. Haha, am I right? I'm an old gammon man. Anyway, it was a great ball from Paul Pogba, wasn't it? Yeah. No, it wasn't. And Wan-Bissaka, I thought Pogba just played it on the turn there. I don't know why. I had my eyes shut saying, please don't score when it happened. I won't lie. And then I woke up. I wasn't sleeping. I woke up and I scored. It was an absolute nightmare. Nightmare, mate, let me tell you. Shelby now with Coop Miners into Ryan Christie. Are we going to score again before half time? That would be wild. Yes, we are. What a hit that was from Ryan Fraser. Wow. Wow, indeed. And we're not doing our goal difference any good by conceding that goal, but we're back in front, and that's the main thing. Fourth goal of the season for Ryan Fraser. Not as much as we would have liked, but him and Almiron both just been taking turns getting injured, which is not what you want. But what a hit that was on his right foot, in off the bar. It looks beautiful when it does that, and he even bounced down behind and then back up. Wonderful stuff. And Liverpool lead as well. Right now, Man U win the league just on goal difference, I believe. So if we could score a couple more, stop them winning the league, and then get enough to finish fourth, that would be amazing. We are underway in the second half, though, and a corner. Ryan Christie puts it in. Garcia heads it off the bar. He would have loved that. A free kick given to Maximan offside. Must have been like on the line or something. Who knows? Arsenal winning. Doesn't matter. They've qualified for the Champions League already, I think. Anyway, it's Ryan Christie now. It's in with Coop Miners. Find a man, Jamal. He does. He finds a Maximan down the line, and that's the man you're wanting to find. Let's be honest. And he does not find in the back of the net. He finds the side netting. That's annoying. Right now, as things stand, we are currently in fourth position. Oh no, now we're back down. Man City have just equalised. I shouldn't have said a thing. Ah, this is weird. Very, very weird. Our goal difference nowhere near as good as theirs, unfortunately. Conceded too many, I'm going to guess. We've scored a lot, we conceded a lot too. Defence is maybe a position we need to improve on next season as we go 3-1 up. Let me know in the comments down below who we should be looking at to bring in, maybe a better left back, maybe even a better right back. Tinyerva can be back up, might put Frimpong out on loan so he can just get some experience playing at a better level. Great finish from Wilson, 24th goal season, emphatic from him. Oh dear lord, come on Everton, please do us a favour, Everton. Nothing's happening with them. But Man United give the ball away, but we have two. Fosu Mensah back with Lindelof, now to Greenwood, up to Marcus Rashford, who puts it over. Yeah, we'll be having that all day long. Keep doing that, Marcus, please. I'm going to make some changes now. Having looked at it, there's no one really there to bring on that will improve things right now. There's no point. Be as well saving the changes for wasting time purposes later on. Yes, I'm a shithouse. Ryan Fraser's popped up. Go away, Ryan Fraser. I want to see what's happening in this game. Where is it? Still 1-1 right now. Not long to go here. We'll tell you, I was about to make some time-wasting substitutions, but it's back with Wan-Bissaka now. He goes into McTominay, out wide now. Oh no, please don't let this happen to us. Great tackle to Niedvai, but Martial now in behind. 3-2, time-wasting substitutions inbound. Can you tell I'm worried? I'm dropping them deeper, basically telling them to regroup and everything, slow the pace down, waste time as much as possible, much lower tempo, just nothing stupid whatsoever. And Longstaff comes off. No, he's already off. Nobody's come off yet. But Christie's dropped deeper. I tell you, I might maybe bring on Chervy or no, Almiron. He'll maybe give us a bit more defensively than Saint-Maximin on that side. That is clever. And then we'll bring on either Morelos or Carroll later on, just to waste time. Carroll probably to hold up the ball. Rashford was broke through. It was a good tackle by Yedvai, but Martial picked it up. A good 1-2 with Mason Greenwood in behind, and a great finish. Dubravka not really with much chance. But let's have a look at see. Oh no, 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 no. Not a highlight after the goal. Please be the highlight because of the substitution, not because of there's something about to happen. Christie now. It's with Paul Dummett. Find a man. Yes, he does. Wilson back with Almiron. Come on, Miggy. Nothing silly. He goes by Wan-Bissaka. Come on, get it in. That's giving it away, mate. That is not what we want. Paul Dummett's marauded forward as well, despite me telling them not to look for the overlap, which is not good whatsoever. And Greenwood. No, no, no. Not a Man United goal now. Not a Man United goal now. Greenwood from range. Wide, thank God. Right, let's put this down. Let's see what happens. Come on, Man City. No, Everton. We need an Everton goal. And big Carroll's going to come on to waste some time. A target man up top. Get defending. Get parking the bus. Jesus Christ, ladies and gentlemen. Right, come on now. Everton. Nothing. We finish fifth, I think. That is not good, unless anything has happened that we didn't see. Wow, how unlucky is that? We finished fifth because of goal difference, conceded far too many. Obviously, Man City have scored a lot of goals. But Man United win the league in the final of this season on goal difference as well. That is tight. And to be fair, that is so much better than I ever thought we'd perform. Europa League football is... Oh, wow. Next season, we're getting Champions League football. Let me tell you that for free. And there we have it. Final position is fifth. And average attendance of 99%. That's not obviously going to happen in real life. None of this is going to happen in real life. The expectation was to finish in the top half. I adjusted that after January since things were going so well. But fifth it is. Longest winning streak. I don't have a clue what it's saying that is. But as you can see there, that's probably the longest winning streak. It's done pretty well. How many games was that? I don't know. I'm not going to count it, let's be honest. This is a nice little feature. Moments to remember. Goal of the season. Ryan Christie in the 5-4 game against Burnley. 3-0 win against Chelsea was the match to remember, and the biggest win was against Millwall in the Cup. Finances, very, very good. But Morelos in there as one of the most shirts sold. That's exciting. All green, very positive. How we lined up. Yes, we all know how I lined up. Yep, superb. Thanks very much. The accolades. What's this then? Fans player of the season, Christie. Young player of the season, Coop Miner, sign of the season. Christie, goal season Christie, goal scorer Wilson, most assists Christie, basically, he cleans up. Wow, wonderful stuff, and I won one manager of the month, I'll take that, not too bad at all. History in the making though, a 5-1 win over Tottenham, and we won the Carabao Cup. Everything is won and lost in the heart of every season, that's been the case for Newcastle United. Thank you Tom Woods of Sky Sports, how Very poignant of you. And not only that, but we get two goals in the Goal of the Season awards for the end of the season as well. Paul Dummett's goal and Ryan Christie's versus Burnley. I've shown you Paul Dummett's one earlier. I'll show you Ryan Christie's now then. He picked up the ball in his own half against Burnley. We were only 1-0 up at the time. It's gone 2-1 apparently very quickly. That was very confusing. But what a hit that was. Very similar to Paul Dummett's actually. But I think he carried it a bit further himself, and that's probably why he got given Goal of the Season. Well deserved, Ryan. Congrats, mate. He is boogieing all night long, let's be honest. Ah, okay, it's all going absolutely mental. We're going to be expanding the stadium, and there's going to be improved training facilities too. Okay, great stuff. I like these new owners. And a whopping initial budget of $59 million. That's not including anything that we make from player sales to good wage budget. Very interesting. You need to let me know in the comments down below who I should be going for at the start of the second season. Who should I sign? Comment down below. And I'll take your suggestions on board. Now, you may have been wondering why I haven't wrapped things up yet and I'm showing you all this. Well, it was for this reason. Arsenal, I only found out were in the Europa League final. And if they won, we would have qualified for the Champions League. But they didn't win. They lost on penalties to Ajax. Europa League it is. But thank you all for getting on board with the Newcastle save this season. It'll carry on tomorrow at 5 o'clock. We'll be back with new signings, a new season underway. So I hope you're excited for that. If you've enjoyed this episode and you're excited for that, smash the like button. Hit subscribe too to stick around for it. We're aiming for 400 subscribers by the end of the month. So every last one of you are very much appreciated. Hit dislike if you didn't enjoy though. And let me know in the comments how I can improve my videos. Thank you all so much for watching. So much boogieing this season, and there's going to be even more next season. Take care.